Hey y'all, and welcome back to my channel. So this Friday's video that's coming up, I'm using a new leave-in and a styler, so of course I need to do the prep work for that video. So I figured I might as well film a video with you all. And since I always wanted to do an assumptions about me video, or is it like this, whatever Pinky and the Brain do, I figured now was a good time. So I'm going to show you my actual routine, what I tend to do off camera. These are my favorite go-to products, and we're going to answer some questions. So let me show you what I'm using first. First of all, one of my favorite shampoos ever, African Pride Moisture Miracle Line. Very inexpensive. It cleans my hair very well, and it does not take all of my moisture away. So I really do like this. It's like $5. $5. Following up for a deep treatment, this is the mother. Listen, I don't care how much it costs, I'm always gonna keep some in stash. This is the Main Choice Original. Is it Core or Alpha now? They changed the name of the collection, but this is my favorite product from the Main Choice. This made me fall in love with the line. But because I'm running out, I think I have very little in the bottle, I'm gonna use my second favorite deep treatment, which is Texture ID. I'm just gonna mix it together. Use as much as I can of this, and this gonna make up for the rest. As far as leave-ins go, I really love this leave-in from Texture ID, but I equally love this leave-in from Carol's Daughter. So today's video, I can't actually style my hair. I'm just showing y'all the products, okay? But these are two of my favorite leave-ins. As far as stylers go, this one is a favorite of mine. It's from TGIN. It's the Miracle Repair RX. And I also love Talia Wajid's Apple and Aloe Hold Me Down Gel. I use that. And then, of course, y'all know my favorite gel of all time. There's no debate. She run this thing. Who run this town tonight? She do. So anyway, since I'm using a leave-in and styler in the next video, I'm actually just gonna go ahead and do the shampooing and deep conditioning with you all. Now let's go and get into these questions. All right, so I gave you all on Instagram and YouTube via the community tab the opportunity to tell me anything you assumed about me, and I'll tell you whether or not it's true. So I'm gonna start with the Instagram questions. The first assumption is, let's see, you are Kojic. Y'all know I grew up sanctified. Y'all know that. No, I am not Kojic. I was actually raised in the PAW. And if you're not familiar with that, it's the Pentecostal Assemblies of the World. It's just some doctrinal differences between PAW and Kojic, but we all some hand clapping, foot stomping, tongue talkers on all of that other good stuff. Next, I assume that you are kind, but not to be messed with. Listen to me. My motto is do no harm, but take no mess. I will never harm you intentionally. If I do harm you, I'll apologize. I try to do right to all mankind, but I ain't taking your mess either. Okay. Next, I assume that you won't respond to people on your YouTube live so you can save it and then bomb. I don't know what that means. The way YouTube live works, I do see a lot of comments, but a lot of times I miss because they come back to back, like in a really fast manner. I answer as much as I can, and the reason I don't save it is, unfortunately, I have a smart mouth, and half the time I say stuff I'm not supposed to say. I'll answer your question if I see it, unless it's something just way too personal, then I'm gonna skip you like I ain't see it. Next, I assume that you cool as heck. I am, child, as long as you don't catch me when I'm PMSing. All right, next. You're very religious and involved in your church. I was raised very much so sanctified. Like Sunday was Sunday morning service. You might have some in the afternoon, and then we had an evening service as well. Monday was prayer night. Tuesday was family, so I got to stay home. Wednesday was Bible study. Thursday was choir rehearsal. Friday was youth night or missionary night. Saturday, sometimes I had to come up there, sometimes I got to stay home. Start over again on Sunday. So when I moved to Texas and it was just me and the boo, I did not go to church really at all. Since I've been back in St. Louis, I'm back at my home church and Barona in town. So, you know, once Rona gone, then I'll be back at church more often. Next, you're a Scorpio. No, I am not. Next, that you're the life of the party before Corona and that you always see the glasses half full. I'm the life of the party with people that I am comfortable with, like my very close friends and family that I feel won't judge me for my quirky little personality. But if I don't know you like that, I ain't gonna say nothing to you at all. Oh, and about the glasses half full part, absolutely. Sometimes, of course, I'm human, I have negative thoughts, but I always bring them back on in because life is what you make it. Next, you're always the funny one. No, and honestly, I don't intend to be funny. I'm just goofy by nature. I really get this mess from my mama. If you ever get to know her, the lady is crazy. Next, you have an amazing heart and you love giving to others. Thank you, sis. I do love giving, like seriously. Next, you were once a tomboy. I wasn't necessarily a tomboy, but I can fight real good. Let me rinse my shampoo out and I'll be back. And we're back. It's time to put on my deep conditioner. And again, I'll be using the Main Choice until this bottle runs out, and then I'll be transitioning to Texture ID. This is seriously, both of these Love them dearly. Okay, so I'm done with the Instagram assumptions. Let's go on to YouTube. First assumption, you lay hands back in the day and you will now if needed. Yep. I would. Yep to both. Now here's the thing. I'm very, very peaceful, very, very zen. I love having a peaceful atmosphere. The only thing that'll make me come out of character is people going after my family. And that, let me kind of transition right there. That's actually why I took down a lot of my content on YouTube that was featuring my husband, or if it showed my, I know my sisters was on there, my best friend, my cousins. I did a lot, especially surrounding my wedding. But here's the thing. Some people can be very, very nasty. And what I mean is, if I speak out and say I don't like something that they love, they'll try to hurt my feelings by saying something negative about my appearance. Oh, you fat, or oh, your bottom teeth are crooked. All these other, child, that don't mean nothing to me, but my trigger is my family. And so some people would say mean things concerning my family members that have been seen on YouTube as a way of getting back at me. One day somebody was mad at me because I said Shea Bae doesn't grow your hair. It helps to retain your hair, but it doesn't grow anything because it's going on your strands and not your scalp. Somebody told me that's why you used to have alopecia and had to wear wigs, and that's why I'm glad your hair fell out. That's the kind of stuff that I deal with secretly behind the scenes that I usually just block and delete. But somebody got mad at me because I said the Kenya Moore hair care was a good line for those who want to blow dry their hair, or those who have finer hair types, but it's not necessarily the best option for those of us who wear our hair in kinky states. Someone got so upset that I said that, that they said my husband doesn't love me. And they said that because I had a video talking about how wedding planning was stressful. And they used that video to tell me, your husband let you plan the wedding by yourself because he don't care nothing about you and he glad that you stressed out too. That's the nasty stuff that I deal with. So I can take it when it's coming to me, but saying stuff about my family, my marriage, different things like that, that made me go ahead and take a lot of stuff offline. So every picture of my mother, my sister, my niece, any of my best friends, husband, anything that is personal, I took that off of my social media, and I'm choosing to keep that private because I will want to come find you. And that's not the thing that I should be doing. So instead of giving people things that are triggering to me, I'm choosing to shield my loved ones to make me not want to fight. So that kind of answers the question. Yes, I will lay hands about my family. About me, honey, if you ain't paying these bills, I don't care what you say. Next. You don't do overtime because you got side hustles. Honey, you know me well. Well, listen, YouTube is my side hustle. For those of you all who don't know, I assumed everyone knew, but for every ad that's played on my videos, YouTube gets a portion and I get a portion of the ad revenue that Google allots or that they collect for that ad placement. And I try not to go overboard in my videos. I usually place one ad for every 4 minutes. So I usually have two ads per video, like at the very beginning, two within the video, and then when the video is over. Some people do one every 2 minutes. I am not that greedy, but I get money for doing YouTube. YouTube is my side hustle. So no, I ain't doing no overtime. I'm gonna get on this good YouTube. Next. I have none. You seem like a pretty straight shooter, honest to me. I honestly see no faking. You don't change for nothing. Thanks, boo. I try my best to be as honest and upfront as I can be. What you see on YouTube is what you get. You might get a different portion of me, meaning I'm not always talking real fast, always real hyper, but that is who I am because I'm just naturally a hyper person like that, child. But yeah, what you see is what you get. I have no reason to lie. I have no reason to front about nothing because I'm a true believer that the truth always don't come out. So ain't no point in pretending, honey. It is what it is. Next, my assumption is that you never really struggle with self-love. That is not true. I have suffered with a lot of, I've had a lot of challenges with self-love. And what has helped me is being in therapy. It's helping me to unlearn negative thinking and to dwell on the positive. I wish I could give you my therapist information, honey. She's amazing. It's just like asking questions that are triggering that helps. But yeah, I have struggled with self-love. But the thing is, I never allow those struggles to overtake what I believe God has put in me. So I'll get in front of people and seem real confident and things like that and can be shaking on the inside, but my faith makes me present myself in a way that you would never know that I'm struggling. You understand what I'm saying? I struggle, but I just don't let you know. Okay, next. I assume you're spiritual, but not religious anymore. I go to church, very much so a Bible believing Christian. I don't have dogmatic views when it comes to Christianity or my faith or anything like that. I am religious in the sense that I read the Bible and go to church and stuff like that, but I'm not religious in the sense where I use my faith as a weapon to make somebody else's quality of life terrible. You understand me? That's it. Next, my assumption is that you're an extrovert and love to socialize in real life. No, ma'am. No. I wouldn't say that. I'm an introvert with extrovert tendencies. Like, in public, I can turn on. You understand? But when I get home, I need to recharge by myself. Next, my assumption is that you play with... My assumption is that you played hair salon with all your friends and your dogs. Yes. Next, I've been a subscriber for a long while now and I just love this channel and show it to everyone who's trying the natural hair journey. I assume nothing and hope everything works in your favor. Keep up the good work and may blessings keep coming your way. Thank you, Millie Ward. I really, really appreciate those words. Y'all give me so much support and y'all such amazing cheerleaders for me, even in some of my weakest moments when y'all may not know that I'm struggling. Y'all have no idea what that support means to me. So from the bottom of my heart, thank you for tolerating my craziness. Next, my assumption is that you can cook very well. What you trying to say? You trying to tell me I'm fat? What you talking about? What you talking about? What you mean? No, I'm just joking, y'all. Yes, I actually can cook very well. I make the best macaroni you'll ever take. Well, no, I ain't gonna say the best, but my macaroni is quite award winning. Next, let me put on Samantha real quick. Tell her hello. Stop fighting it. Stop fighting, especially to you real serious folks. Stop fighting and say hi, Samantha. Say hi, Samantha. Let us continue. My assumption, you are the center of your circle and will always make everyone laugh or be the first one over if your girl needs you. Oh, and you say whether or not your girl has a booger in her nose, so you won't be embarrassed. Honey, you're not gonna misrepresent me in public. So yes, if you got something in your nose, I'm gonna tell you just cause I love you. Secondly, the center of your circle. I can honestly say with the girlfriends that I had, all of us are the pillar of our circle at some point in time. So sometimes it's me, sometimes it's others, but I can definitely say I thank God for my girlfriends because we support each other. Next, my assumption is that you don't want children soon. You are correct, honey. I really don't. I want children in the future, just not this year. Next, my assumption is that you're the life of the party. Every time I show up. Amongst family and friends, you are the one friend everyone wants to be there no matter how big or small the reason is. Thank you, darling. Among my close family and friends, that is true. But honestly, all of my friends are clowns and some of them are worse than me. So yeah, I could be the life of the party one day. It could be somebody else the next. Birds of a feather flock together. Next, I assume, in parentheses, want you to have a video talking about God. Not a long video, but it could be about what God is to you or how you've progressed, or maybe you can teach us a little something and pray for your viewers. I wouldn't be mad at that. Okay, so I don't necessarily want to make a video preaching or nothing like that. I feel like what's in you always gonna come out, so at some point God used to come up in a conversation with me anyway. But I feel like I know my role on YouTube and I don't necessarily want to make a video preaching. I feel like me just being my authentic self and realizing that some people are going through stressful moments and they just need a reason to laugh, and I give them that sometimes. I feel like even God is glorified in those moments. So I don't necessarily want to make a video being real preachy or nothing like that. But I feel like just me being myself should be enough. Not to say I would never, you know, talk about a testimony or something like that. I talk about a lot, but I just don't see me, you know, turn with me in your Bibles. You understand? I wouldn't do that. Next, you're really good at editing videos because your videos aren't super long, which I love. So I almost watch your entire video. But thank you, darling. I don't like long, drawn out, boring videos. So I try not to give y'all that. I try to, at certain timings, say something real silly or something just to break up the ice. So it's not just like womp, 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 womp. Because I don't watch that. I just fast forward through people's videos that do that. So I try to produce content that I want to. So that's kind of my influence. So thank you for acknowledging that. I appreciate you. Next, my assumption is that you've been independent your whole life. Honey, listen, you own the money. Like, independent to the point of being hard-headed at the time and get myself in some jams. But yes. Next, I assume that you were short. Forget you. I am 5'4½". So I think that's pretty average, but to some people that's short. I assume that you didn't work and that you were a stay-at-home housewife. I was surprised when you said you have a corporate job. I don't know why, but I was. Maybe because of your personality. You're wild and I don't equate that to the corporate world. Okay, so I know when to turn it on and off. And so because YouTube is honestly, at the end of the day, entertainment, I turn it on. But when I'm at work, I get that check and I do it well. But yeah, I do still work my 9-to-5 to this day. Next, I don't like to assume anything about anyone, but I do assume that you have pretty good role models in your life because your attitude and personality is bomb. Thank you, darling. I do have some amazing role models. I've been blessed with them my whole life, and they keep their foot on my neck if I get to tripping. So that's why you get this. Next, my assumption is that you're extremely blessed and highly favored by God. Abba! That's true. Next, you're the friend that will tell it like it is. You'll say what needs to be said, even if your friend doesn't want to hear it. Absolutely true. But I do understand timing, because sometimes it's just not the right time to say things. But in the right time, when I feel like it's right, I'm going to tell you what it is, child. Next! I feel like you're from Atlanta or somewhere south. No, I am from the city of St. Louis, Missouri, which, although it's Midwestern in the region, we're very, very Southern here culturally. Listen to me, we Southern. Next, I assume you're really cool in person. Thank you, darling. If you think I'm cool on YouTube, that's exactly what you're gonna get in person. Next, I assume you always helped people but didn't realize your gift is so powerful. Thank you, I appreciate those words. I assume you're Sagittarius. No. Next, you have a lot of friends because of your sense of humor. I could, but I also have a very blunt tongue and everybody can't handle that. So I have a lot of associates that can hang out with me. But as far as friends go, I got the same few homegirls that I grew up with. The friend that is the newest to me, we met when I was a sophomore and she was a freshman in high school. And I graduated in 2003. So yeah, we've been around each other for a long time. Those that can handle me are the ones that can handle me. Next. Assume you haven't done illegal drugs before. You assumed correctly. Never done it. Next, you are a low tolerance person. I'm very nice, I'm very chill, but I ain't with no foolishness, and I will set order when needs to be done. I'm very low tolerance, for real. Next, you're a pretty cool chick that don't do drama and keep your friends circle like your curls tight. Honey, you are on the money. Seriously, especially about the drama. Honey, I'm getting too old. I don't need no high blood pressure. I don't need to be catching no cases. I don't do no dramatic people or no negativity or nothing. Just keep it chill. Next, I assume you're spontaneous and a risk taker and you like to reinvent yourself a lot. You can tell by how I treat my hair. Yes, all of that is true. I'm very spontaneous. Like right now, I just dyed my hair black and I already was like, you know what? I'm going back red. Yep, I'm gonna do it. So yeah, I'm very spontaneous. Now, listen, I ain't crazy with that either. You know, like, I ain't a nut, but I am spontaneous. Next, I'm so glad that most of these, well, all of them have been really good. I do appreciate that y'all assume good things about me. I'm so special, child. Okay, let me get back to it. My assumption is that you're more comfortable on camera than you are in real life. At times, yes, and it depends on who I'm around. Like I said before, I'm very, very shy in public, especially around people that I'm not used to. I'm very, very quiet, but I'm just talking to a phone right now. Like, that doesn't bother me. I assume that you're an outgoing woman with a huge heart. Love your personality and your content. P.S. I told my 19-year-old daughter not to judge me. Judge her mama. So you're rubbing off on me already. Thank you, child. Y'all have made my day with these very good assumptions. I really do try to put out good energy. That is something that I made a decision to do. I think, like, sometime last year, I was just like, even in products that I don't like, I'm going to deliver the message in a way that's not toxic. Because you never know what somebody's going through when they see your video. And I want y'all to always feel uplifted when you watch my material. So thank y'all for assuming good about me, because I really do try to be a good person. So if y'all have any questions, leave them down below. I'm getting ready to record Friday's video, which will be, I believe, y'all see it Friday. Come back to see me on Friday for Black Girl Friday, and y'all see what I style my hair with. And with that being said, I'm out of here. Bye.